Hi, Toastmaster Art here with another YouTube video from the Toastmasters International Successful Club Series. Today we're going through the Meeting Roles and Responsibilities presentation, which provides an overview of club meeting roles and identifies the ways that Toastmasters can influence and enhance the quality of club meetings. Toastmasters who take on specific meeting roles are fundamental to a meeting's success. We're going to look at speaking and non-speaking roles, and also examine how the club officers contribute to a well-run meeting. This is new material for new members, but I've seen experienced members at clubs seemingly in need of this training as well. That said, let's all, regardless of how much time we've been a Toastmaster, learn together in Meeting Roles and Responsibilities. Here are functionary positions, or meeting roles, that you are going to find assigned to members at a typical Toastmasters meeting. Let me note for you now that we're going to take a somewhat cursory look at the roles first. Then I'll show you where to go to find more detailed information. The Toastmaster reviews the agenda, ensures it's complete, and prepares and presents introductions for prepared speakers, though some clubs present introductions for other functionaries as well. The Table Topics Master ensures every member has an opportunity to participate, giving priority to those without speaking roles, and inviting guests to join in. Prepared speakers share speeches from the Toastmasters manuals. The General Evaluator introduces his evaluation team, calls for reports from his team, and evaluates the meeting at a general level. Prepared speech evaluators help speakers by completing the speech manual's evaluation form and providing a verbal review. A helpful resource is the Toastmasters International Effective Speech Evaluation Booklet. You can download a free copy of this by searching for item 200 on the TI website. The timer helps speakers learn to convey their speech within a given time limit. The grammarian assists participants in polishing language skills. The AH counter aids us in eliminating our use of verbal crutches. Now we'll look at the meeting roles, which you will find at some, but not every, club. Wordmaster. By encouraging use of the word of the day while speaking, the role helps us increase our vocabulary. The quote master shares an inspiring or thematic quotation. The joke master gets the meeting started with a little humor. This is Toastmasters, so keep it unoffensive. The invocator gives a short inspirational message. And if the club has members vote for best prepared speaker, table topics speaker, or prepared speech evaluator, you might have a vote counter to tally the results. The parliamentarian ensures things go by the book, the book being Robert's Rules of Order in most cases. The contributions of officers at a club meeting are not as obvious, but they're vital to a meeting's success. The sergeant-at-arms handles room setup and breakdown and greets guests. Your club president provides leadership and sets the meeting's mood. He's also going to lead the business session, if you have one. The Vice President of Education plans meetings, charts members' accomplishments, and addresses their needs and guests' questions after a meeting. The Vice President Public Relations generates publicity to attract guests and greets them. Your Vice President Membership reports on membership building activities, coordinates new member induction ceremonies, and greets guests. The Club Secretary keeps meeting minutes, definitely for business sessions, but also a good idea for each club meeting, especially if you desire to track attendance and such. She can circulate an attendance sheet to help in that regard. At a given club meeting, the treasurer might be asked to briefly share the current bank account balance, a report of recent expenditures, and any dues issues. I want to provide you with more meat than was on the slides from TI, which we've just viewed. Those are a helpful introduction, and the PDF document which accompanies the presentation gives a bit of information about each role, but I believe Toastmasters need more detail. Let's revisit the assigned meeting roles slide. You see here the 8 roles we briefly covered, but to where can you go for more comprehensive information? How about a place I discovered, perhaps for the first time, after I had been a Toastmaster for years? It's the back of the book. All of these roles are described in detail at the back of the Competent Communication Manual. In a bit less detail, they're also covered on the TI website at the address shown. Lastly, you can order the publication, A Toastmaster Wears Many Hats, for only $1 from TI. Now we'll revisit the Club Officers Meeting Roles slide. You see here the 7 officer positions which were discussed, but again, to where can you go for more comprehensive information? Back to the back of the book. Duties or standards for each officer, both outside of and at a club meeting, are described. For you folks who are officers at present, pull out the club leadership handbook you've been diligently bringing to officers' training sessions, which you are attending twice a year. Each officer position has material describing what that person does before or outside of a meeting and during or at a meeting. All right, that's good for finding out more about what one does when serving in one of these roles, but there are additional resources that make the job easier. Here's something of which too many clubs that I have visited have not availed themselves: a log or worksheet for each role. I don't believe these are available in any form from TI, so it's up to us to create them if we want to use them. Take a look at the Ah Counters log on the screen. This was developed years ago for one of my clubs. Thanks, Dave. And I liked it so much that I improved it, and also produced or improved other such worksheets, like one for the General Evaluator, another for the grammarian, for the timer, and even a template which allows the wordmaster to print out in large typeface the word of the day for taping on the wall, or little slips to hand out to attendees. There's also a worksheet for the wordmaster to help her keep track of usage of the word of the day. All are branded to the club, as you can see at the top of each page. It's worth noting that each of these worksheets comes with a set of instructions. It's difficult to read the source line at the bottom of the page on the instructions page here, but it says, Source: Toastmasters International Communication and Leadership Program, Catalog Number 225, page 72. What's that, you ask? the original name of the competent communication manual. Like I said back on slides 4 and 5, go to the back of the book for role descriptions. I added the instructions to the worksheet file because I wanted it all in one place. Both my clubs use these worksheets, and I've also shared them with clubs in Area 73, of which I am currently the director, others in District 38, and even a club down in Georgia. If your club is not using worksheets, I recommend that you do. If you would like me to help you develop one, reach out and ask. To get more than the passing glance at these worksheets that I provided on the previous slides, you can access all of them at the Area 73 page shown here. I've expanded the club resources menu so you can see exactly where to go to grab the files. The documents are exported as PDF files, except for the WordMaster template and instructions, which is a rich text format or RTF file, and uploaded to the member downloads section of our club's Free Toast host site, so that when a member signs up for a role, he can download the form and instructions he needs to adequately serve in that role. Read the instructions, know what you're doing, print the logger worksheet, and bring it to the meeting. Simple, right? Let's wrap it up with the final slide in the TI presentation. Teamwork is essential to the success of a Toastmasters club and to its members. When members understand how best to serve in meeting roles, the meeting as a whole is more professional and enjoyable. Because I perceive a great need, I added a lot to this presentation. I hope that you got a lot out of it. Working together, we will make our clubs and their meetings the best they can be. To be notified when additional educational presentations are uploaded, please subscribe to this channel. I hope that you were all edumacated today. Educating and thus bettering my fellow Toastmasters is a passion of mine, and I am here to help if I can. I would be interested in hearing from you either by email or submitted comments as to how effective you found this presentation. Make it a great Toastmasters day. Go G! Mr. Toastmaster.